I'm Geoff Boyle, I'm a DP, and I spent 40 years making mistakes, which is the way I learned how to do it right. I still make mistakes, but hopefully not the same ones. That's an interesting question. It's a very academic question, a scene-referred image or an artistic image. If you mean, do you want to make something look realistic and as if it is unlit, or do you want to light it for dramatic effect? A scene that uses the location lights as a reference, yes, every time. When you go on location, you look at the scene, you talk to the director, and you are deciding on, we've already decided actually before you've ever gone, on the look of the film. Are you going to work with the look of the locations and try and make it look as natural as possible? Or are you going to try and make the pictures look as powerful as possible, manipulate them more? The artistic choice, if you want. But then it's an artistic choice to keep it as a scene-referred look anyway. Is digital technology catching up with film or surpassing it in terms of color rendition, dynamic range, and so on? I really don't care. You get asked to produce a film look, and people forget how bad film was. They have this rosy glow of film looking wonderful. Film used to be bad. It used to clip in the highlights the same way video does. It used to clip in the shadows the same way video does. And Wendy Watkin used to use AG for the simple reason, quote, "I know it won't fuck me." And what he meant by that was when it hit a highlight, instead of clipping hard like the medium speed Kodak stock of that time, it gently rolled off. It was subtle in its finish. The same in the shadows. It didn't suddenly go black. It went dark grey, darker, 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 very gently. And we've got now with digital imaging to a position where we can reproduce that. In fact, we can probably exceed what film can do in most cases. But do I want it to look like film? No, I want it to look good. Does it look like film if it looks good? Maybe. I don't care. I'm using a program called Film Convert at the moment, which they've done a great job of emulating measured all the different film stocks, and you can emulate the different film stocks. But what they've done that's wonderful is you can dial the grain in and out. If you want it to look like that film, but you don't like grain, you can dial the grain out. If you want to take a little bit of Kodak 1.3, but you don't want to take it all the way to that look, you can slide it in and out. You've got a freedom with digital imaging that you never had with film. People obsess about, is it as good as film? Does it look like, who gives a shit? Does it make nice pictures is actually what matters. And we've gone through a stage where the answer was no, it didn't make nice pictures. The first steps in digital cinema making were horrid. I understand why it was the way it was, but it was too early. The first camera that really started to approach the kind of images I'd like to make was the Viper, which came out about 10 years ago. Now with the Alexa, with the Dragon, with the F65, we're getting to the point where the camera's irrelevant, that they each have an individual look, so you'll pick them for the look rather than any other reason, rather than a technical reason. The same way that you would choose a film stock. We used to have high contrast stocks, low contrast stocks, high saturation, low saturation, and so on. And we're getting to that point with cameras. Of course, persuading a production manager that you want to use an F65 for one shot and then later on you want to switch to a Dragon or an is difficult. Well, we can change it all in post. No, you can't. Okay, so which aspects of a camera influence the look of it most? Because of the amount of testing I've done and because of the amount of shooting I do with different cameras, I know that different cameras will produce different results in different situations. But it's a combination of camera, of lenses, of the way you light it. Everything works together. You've got to have high dynamic range, because if you have limited dynamic range, you're fighting from the beginning. It's got to have a good color response. And by good color response, I don't mean necessarily a totally accurate one, but one that's pleasing. If you're shooting raw on everything, which I prefer to do, there's no question, and I prefer uncompressed raw, because some cameras shoot compressed raw, you produce a huge amount of data. Now, I don't see that as a problem, but some people see a lot of data as a problem. I think it's just something you have to deal with, and you find the methods to deal with it. it's a whole thing of balance, that you choose the format you're going to work with according to all the implications. I want to get the best pictures I can. And if that means using uncompressed high bit depths, high data rates, then that's what we'll do. And we'll suffer whatever we have to do to get those pictures. Far too many people compromise. That'll do. That's good enough. That'll be okay. No, it won't be. No, it isn't. So what do I look for when I'm choosing a camera for shooting? Well, the answer is I'm always looking for more. I want the most. I want the highest data rate, the highest bit rate. I want the most information, because then we can change it. Producers are not going to want that, because more data means more transfer time, more post time possibly, although I think people exaggerate all of that. I want the most flexibility I can get. If you don't have high dynamic range, high bit rate, high bit depth, then your choices become more and more limited. Not my choices. I can make a decision. I can say, I like the look of this, let's shoot it like this. Shall we burn this look in? Which you can do with the Amira now. You can put a lookup table into the Amira, decide in advance, grade a test shot, decide that's the look of your film, and you can burn it into your material. Now, I would love to do that. But I don't know any I know very few directors who would be willing to do that, because it would remove totally their chance of changing their minds.